It's Nina Fiore with the Astoria Film Festival, coming to you from Film Festival Live and O'Prime TV, ready to have you meet some more of our amazing filmmakers coming up in Festival 2021.
The Astoria Film Festival is a 501c3 nonprofit organization. We produce an annual film festival that highlights short films, feature films, web series, and podcasts from filmmakers around the world, and hold meetups and smaller screenings throughout the year to support local filmmakers. Our founder and executive director, Nina Fiore, grew up in Astoria, New York, and worked in television, digital media production for many years with MTV, PBS, Viacom, Sundance Channel, and many others. She also worked in after-school education. Nina began the festival with the hopes of uniting students interested in careers in film, television, and digital media production with local experts in the field. The majority of proceeds from our festival go into creating education workshops for local schools, after schools, and community centers. We also run a Film Fellows program where we provide work, internships, mentorships, and training for students ages 15 to 25 with an interest in film, television, and digital media production. Most of our programming is now done virtually via Zoom for ages 8 to 12, 13 to 18, and 15 to 25. If you'd like more information about our organization, please visit AstoriaFilmFestival.org. Thank you.
Thank you so much and welcome back. Our first guest is Rachel Domond, who's a choreographer and filmmaker.
Have us in here for you. We were made to love. We were made to love. You were sent for me too. We were made to love. Oh, I've never seen anything. You're much more than human being. Extraordinary machine. Oh, I never loved. Never loved someone like this. All I know is have us in here for you. We were made to love. We were made to love.
Rachel, how are you?
I'm fine. Thank you for having me. So I really appreciate it.
I appreciate it. I'm happy to see you. So, you know, I've known Rachel since, what, 2016? Where we met at the Boys and Girls Club where she was teaching dance. And where she had been teaching dance since she was what? How old?
Like 15.
It's just crazy. And yeah, now
like
you're
15,
now,
16 years old.
So you attended Boys and Girls Club, took dance there, and then became a teacher there.
Yeah,
and then now
so
you're.
I first attended the Boys and Girls Club. I believe I was like 11 years old in middle school. My parents made sure that I had something to do after school. you know, after school and middle school. And I was very new to the Astoria, Long Island City area because I'm originally from a different part of Queens, but I had went to a different school, so I needed to, you know, keep myself productive, keep myself busy outside of school. So I went to the Boys and Girls Club. I had already been dancing before that, but, you know, the dance program is what attracted me because I found myself surrounded by people that looked like me that were doing things that I liked. So I made sure to get involved in there. So I went there from about 11 to about 15. Then I started working there through SYP, which is Summer Youth Employment Program, which is like a government summer program to ensure that youth have jobs, temporary jobs for the
government. Yeah, we actually just had about 15 SYP interns with us at Astoria Film Festival this summer. They just finished their routine, their route, whatever it's called.
Yeah, so that's how I got involved there. And then after that summer, they just loved me. So they kept me there, and I've been working there since I was about 15.
And then now
I go to CUNY Hunter College, right? I'm studying dance. I'm studying dance education because it's been my passion. I feel like dance is a great way to connect with children, especially with now that times are changing. Kids need to, like, really illuminate their creative sides. Like, they need to show that off. Like, it's very important, and I feel like it's something that doesn't get highlighted or appreciated or, like, tackled within, like, the education system, right? Some of these world's best inventions are because people are creative, right? Not everyone learns through reading in a book. Some people need to think, so people need to innovate, people need to create. So I feel like dance is a great way to do that for the youth, and I feel like it's a way to, like, be a positive role model towards them, right? Because, you know, dance is a physical activity, right? You use your body, and, you know, especially with kids who are, like, heavily influenced by outside people or social media, like, I feel like dance is a good way to stay positive, for them to be creative, like, to love themselves, and I just love being that for them. Especially because I like to represent for minority women who are not a size 2, right? Even in the dance world, there's stigmas against, you know, what a dancer body is or what a ballet body is or, like, yeah, or what, you know, what a dancer should look like. And I am not none of those things. So I just continue to serve as an example. So it's my due diligence. Like, it's my purpose.
No, it's beautiful. I've seen it for years, and I love to see its evolution because, yes, representation is so needed in so many ways, and you represent so beautifully, and you encourage so beautifully. Like, I've seen you with kids, and you're just wonderful with them. So what made you decide to do this film and this specific choreography?
So this film was actually a project for one of my courses at Hunter, Composition 1. So Composition is basically like a 3-part series that we need to take for my degree, which allows us to create our own choreography. So I had complete creative control. So what I wanted to do was step out of my comfort zone. So as a dancer, I have strong hip hop background, and that's because I come from a low income family, and hip hop classes are more affordable than ballet or contemporary or the other technical classical styles. My mother just made sure that, you know, as far as dance, she can put me in what she could afford. And hip hop was always low to no money, you know, to no money. So I had creative control, and, you know, that's always been my strength. So I've always taught that primarily, but I am, you know, I teach everything, but I've always taught that primarily. So being that I had full creative control, I'm like, okay, I'm going to step out of my comfort zone, right? I'm going to create something that is not like me, just to, like, not prove, but, like, just to strengthen, like, representation, you know? Like, I'm going to create something that people don't see every day. I'm going to create something that has a deeper meaning, that is, that I just represent. I'm sorry if I sound, repetitive, but I always stand, like, consistent, and, like, my intentions are always consistent. My intentions are always consistent when it comes to my dancing, my teaching, my creating. So the genre is Afro-modern genre, right? So I chose to film it in a white background so that the focus could be on me. So that, you know, you could see a blank background, but you just see my body. Like, the focus is my body moving. So the song Made to Love, it's actually a song by John Legend. It's very old. And briefly, it's just about how we are not just
being very old here. Is relative.
Okay, sorry, not very old. Maybe like 10 years.
Yeah. Okay, not very old. But go ahead. Go on. Right. I know.
Bad choice of words.
Can I just interrupt to say that my first day at Boys and Girls Club, what was it that I was wearing a pair of shoes that were older than you? You were like, those shoes are older than I am. Yes. And I was like, oh, geez. Yes.
So Nina had on a pair of Doc Martens that were older than me. So when Nina first met me, guys, she met me when in 2016 or 17. Yeah. I was about 19 or 20 years old. And she had a pair of Doc Martens that were older than me. So Nina met me when I was like fresh out of high school, you know, just graduated. Yeah, that's funny. I totally forgot about that.
So that's like, why I had to say old. That, like, you know, time is relative here. But sorry, love, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
It's okay.
You were saying about the John Legend song.
Yeah, so the John Legend song is about 10 years old. It's called Made to Love. So basically what he was saying is that we're more than just beings. Like, we all have a purpose. Like, we're meant to love. We're meant to appreciate, right? We're meant to be surrounded by each other. We're meant to just show and reveal. So that's just what I wanted to do. I wanted to highlight something that doesn't get a lot of light and make it into something that can be loved and appreciated, right? So you saw my African-American self, my size 12 self, doing Afro-modern choreography to Made to Love by John Legend.
Yes. I love it.
And it was, all my professors loved it, right? I got an A, of course. It was my first, actually, to be honest, I think it was one of my first pieces that I choreographed in that style. And that style.
Yeah, I hadn't seen work like that from you before.
Wow, yeah. Yep. When I teach different styles to kids, I do something like very little, but I don't think I've ever created a piece like that primarily, now that I just thought about it. And I love that I was able to do that on my very first chance for the school to see. It was on the school website. You know, everybody saw it. My professor loved it. My friends loved it. People who know me as a dancer knows, like, okay, you did something different. And you look good. Like, it wasn't bad. You look good. So I guess that was kind of like a milestone in my journey, and I just can't wait to keep going and do more.
And so then what's next, later then? On,
give it to the kids. So as of now, I do like private lessons. You know, with the pandemic and everything, you know, I've been teaching dance since I was 15, right? I'm 24 now. I've been working nonstop before the pandemic, right? I've been working nonstop. So I figured, you know, with the pandemic starting, I was like, okay, I'm gonna take this time to just chill and strengthen my craft, right? Be a better dancer, be a better choreographer. Oh my God, do you see my little brother? Be a better dancer, be a better choreographer, be a better creator, be a better educator. Take this time to strengthen you, Rachel, right? Take a break from teaching. Take this time to strengthen you, to explore, so that when you do get back teaching in the school setting or, you know, in, you know, any building setting, that you just come strong. So as of now, I do private lessons on demand, but right now I'm taking the time to just strengthen my own skill, and maybe in about 6 months, I'll get back to teaching full time.
Well, it's God willing, we can all get back to life in 6 months.
Yes.
Oh, I can't even.
Yeah. Right.
Truly. And you will be teaching at our festival. Rachel will be teaching a dance workshop at the festival in the back lot with a bunch of other film-related workshops. There'll be a fight scene workshop, filmmaking workshop, and Rachel's dance workshop. So I look forward to that because I haven't seen you in ages. So
yes,
I can't wait.
I miss you so much.
Same here.
Crazy times, but we do what we can. We keep going. At least we try to keep going.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so that's what it is. I mean, Nina knows that this is something that I plan on doing, you know, for the rest of my life. You know, dance is always something that's kept me happy, you know, kept me neutral.
And also, I think it's interesting when you said, you know, the kids need it to express themselves, to learn. But also, during the pandemic, like, what saved a lot of people's sanity? You know, art, film, dancing,
art,
you know, my son film, and I dance every night, you know, because we couldn't get out, right? So that was a saving grace that we had. So yeah, I think it's so important. But thank you so much for being on with us today. I can't wait to see you at the festival. Yay.
I love you so much, Nina. I love you so much. I love you so
Same.
much.
I love you. I love you more.
Okay. Thank you so much, guys. Your name was Will, right? His name was Will.
Yes, his name is Will.
Okay. Thank you again, Will. Thank you too.
Bye, sweetheart. Thank you.
Okay. Bye. Everyone have a great day.
So that was Rachel. You can see why I love her. Our next guest is Shidan Majidi with his film, Me, the Other. He's the director, and it's an amazing, beautiful piece.
How do you explain to someone that someone else matters? It's hard.
He told me almost immediately. He wanted to make sure that it was very clear that I knew his situation. No
papers, no fear. Before you even said one word, you fit the stereotypic mold, right?
You're bound to feel like the other when where everyone else seems to be equal. And that is not fair.
It doesn't.
Shidan, welcome. How are you?
Ask again.
Shidan, welcome. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you for inviting me. This is a wonderful platform and festival. Thank you. Thank you for including us.
So happy to have you here. We've talked a little bit on the phone and in DMs, so I'm glad to actually see your face and speak to you for a while.
Nina, let me stop you. Okay. I think it's his phone that's doing that noise.
Okay.
Because if I do this, it goes away.
So, and then he's muted. Is that what that is?
Yeah. So for some, is he? Are you holding your phone, Shidan? Is he holding it?
Can you guys hear me?
I can hear you. Will, can you hear him?
I can hear but the crackling is what's bothering me.
He's trying to fix the crackling sound. He's asking if you are holding the phone, maybe. That might be causing it. Are we live?
No, it's not. We are, but it's okay. One other thing is that are you in Wi-Fi or are you on cellular?
Now you're kind of frozen.
I'll stop. Hold on. I'm stopping.